We are here for one reason. To come together as a group, as a community, and for a time, forget everything in the world outside, and as one, act like idiotic assholes.
Well, the fucking van broke down again today.
Did it?
It broke down like 5 times today. It's better than yesterday, which was like 20 times. It won't start anymore. Is it working out?
Yeah.
I just wanted to show you guys what a geek I am. First of all, my pants. Oh, whoops. Oh, fuck, get in there, you bitch. First of all, my pants, because I'm convinced that like I'm like skinnier than I really am, I bought these at 34, but I'm really at 36. Oh, I bought 32s, like an idiot. Look, it just bust out everywhere and it's broke. I spent like $80 on these fucking pants so I could be more like a hip-hop kid or somebody who wears big pants. But anyway, they're not even pants, they're shorts, but they're practically down to my foot. But anyway, this is the gayest thing. Look at this. Look at this. This is why my girlfriend doesn't have to worry about me cheating on her when I'm on tour. Oh, wow, it's the light's turning on. That's a design flaw right there. Okay. This is why she doesn't have to worry about it, because who the fuck is gonna wanna fuck around with a dude who wears one of these? And has the added additional advantage of keeping my pants up. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's an ugly fucking car. Look. And it's so poorly designed, you can't really get it out. God. Fuck. It's like, hold on, I'm gonna stab you in a minute. Wait a minute. God damn it. That is bullshit. Here we go. Yeah, I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm fucking like that guy that Daredevil fought or something. With the cell phone. Come at me, punk. Come at me. All right, turn that thing. When I tell you to turn it off, don't turn it off.
Something's coming.
Yeah, it's just like my farts actually melt the fabric of my pants. My underwear. I have to wear like, I put like a special gauze pad in the underwear so it actually doesn't like set. And I drench it in like, it's like an asbestos pad so it doesn't actually, my pants don't catch on fire. I have one of those flatulent asses. There's something wrong with me. I sweat too much and I fart way too much. But I, you know, I don't know. Anyway, I was doing something. I'm not sure what it was.
Did you ever think about selling your underwear on eBay?
I'm sure I could get money for it, the sick fuckers. The next thing I'm going to sell on eBay is the stupidest thing ever. I've been selling paintings and doing pretty decent with that, but basically for the last 15 years, I've been saving every single sticky note I ever wrote. You know, people write sticky notes to themselves, and I use them all the time. And in fact, I have sticky notes right here, ready to go at any moment. And ready to stick, write, disseminate information. But anyway, I saved them all, every single one of them. I have like a giant box now, like this big, full of sticky notes from 15 years. Some of the fucking phone numbers in there are unbelievable. And I'm gonna sell that on eBay. And then some poor fuck can give me a whole bunch of money to sit around and go through every single sticky note I've ever written. It's gonna be cool. Anyway, I have to actually go do some work now, I think. So I'm gonna run away from you.
Michael Dirks, ladies and gentlemen, on guitar! Brad Roberts on drums! Oh my God, it's another DBX tour! This song's called... Damn! That!
Money!
Damn it! money, money, money.
GTN!
I'm Dave, Dave Brockie, this is me. Just did a show here in Philly. This is as raw as it gets. And this is how addictive rock and roll is. I'm 39 years old, and I am still addicted to playing rock and roll as much as possible, and I will not stop playing rock and roll until the Rock and Roll Handlers League comes out and like sedates me and puts me away in some kind of public rest home, because there should be that kind of stuff. I mean, they have like unions for like metal workers and people who like wipe up the toilet, but people who are artists, we don't get shit. I'm 39, I've been doing this my whole life, and I'm not saying that 39 is really anything to be a proud of, except for the fact that I've survived this long without any help from you, United States, except for all the cool people that live here and stuff. But anyway, I would just like to say to people out there that might be watching this right now and wondering why they're watching this, fucking stop watching this. Get out there and do something. I'm about to blow my nose.
What I mean is like when those guys like on in the government or whatever or NASCAR talk, they've got like 500 microphones like all smushed into their face. I always thought that was so stupid. I mean, why did he just have one? But now I see why. Fuck those guys from the government. Give me 500 microphones. Until you can't even see my face.